that's going to be all for Jared Weaver. 9 runs allowed on the season coming into tonight. 8 allowed tonight with a potential 9th.
We was 90 miles out of Atlanta by sundown, rolling out of Georgia State. We had more trouble than turned into a struggle halfway across Alabama. And that hound broke down and left us all stranded in downtown Birmingham. Right away I bought me a through train ticket riding across Mississippi clean. And I was on that midnight flyer out of Birmingham smoking into New Orleans. Somebody helped me get out of Louisiana, just help me get to Houston town. There are people there who care a little about me and they won't let the poor boy down. Sure as you bone, they bought me a silk suit and put luggage in my hand. And I woke up high on a jet to the promised land. Make it to the telephone. Los Angeles, give me Norfolk, Virginia, Tidewater, 410-09. Tell the folks back home, this is the promised land calling and the poor boy's on the line.
Hey, who's the dude with the long hair dragging the infield? Tim Toon is his name, from Weber State. Mr. Irrelevant, the last pick in the NFL draft, number 255 by the Detroit Lions. That's what you get to do, is drag the infield here at the Big A. Congratulations, Mr.
Hey,
Toon.
If you're drafted at all by the NFL, you're pretty darn good.
If you don't believe, listen up to my new CD, Sham On. I got shit running through my brain, so intense that I can't explain. All alone in my white boy pain, shake your booty while the band complains. Rockin'.
quiet riot den. I'm rocking the suburbs, except that they were talented. I'm rocking the suburbs. I take the checks and face the facts. The suburbs turn with computers, fixes all my shitty tracks.
He was trying to deceive Cano and act like, you know, he had an easy beat on it. And then I thought I was way out. You know, outfielders, a lot of times when you stand there, you try to hold that runner. Ah, you're going to give his money back, too. I like that. See, Torrey Hunter, we said he was a pretty good guy.
Oh, the guy dropped his glasses.
Was that it? Glasses?
And he wanted to pay him for his help. And Hunter doesn't need your money.
I like you. Now, you stole a lot of my hits, but I like you now.
He doesn't need the cash, that's for sure. Here's a look.
Here's the glasses. So the guy thinks he's a Pearl Vision.
Yeah.
I told you he likes to smile.
He got a kick out of that.
Thank you. 2-1 to Shug. Foul back over the screen. Now 2-2 with Mike Trout waiting on deck.
See JB Shug take a little smell of the bat right there. A lot of players believe that if you foul the ball off sometimes the right way, there's a little bit of a smoky residue from the seams burning off the wood of the bat. Check this out. Anything there? A little barbecue flavor maybe? Ted Williams was the one who really, I think, was credited with first noticing that smell.
He had that extra sense. And J.B. Shug, after smelling the bat, with a leadoff home run for the Angels, his second of the season. And Tom, you mentioned the Angels lead the majors in home runs now with 28.
Yeah, 28 home runs, and again, first inning offense, getting on the board quickly. Doesn't get any quicker than that.